VH1 picked 4 independent bands,
put them on the road.
Cameras falls everywhere.
We play the same towns, different venues every night.
And we live on $20 a day.
We only have 2 or 3 days to promote each show.
Whichever band can draw the most people and make the most money will stay on tour, and the people who don't make as much
will be kicked off and sent home.
I know in my heart of hearts that nothing is more important to any of us than this band. The guys in the band used to call me an anti-hero. On stage, I'm such a rocker dude. I'm crazy, and I'm weird, but I'm not cool.
That's sweet.
I think that we're going to San Francisco.
Sutton, he's a brilliant songwriter. As a person, he's a total mess.
I think they think of me as on the edge of some kind of disaster.
Beastie, you're singing out of key.
Bob is the oldest member of the band.
You can't play bars forever, you know? You really have to try and try to move up or be successful, you know?
Sam Clam Disco, here we come!
AP's the jackass. He's just a jackass.
All loves attention. Everyone in this band is an attention hound.
Want to smoke us a little? Okay.
No, I'm not getting anything.
Ramsey is not so, me, like everybody else.
It's not necessarily my personality to be really flamboyant.
Oh, there's the band.
You got the great one.
Kick ass. Look at that.
I got water.
Wow.
Pretty cool,
dude.
Hey.
Oh, what's that?
Dominic's calling all women to the stabbing cabin.
We're going to drink, we're going to party, and we're going to meet chicks. And if you don't want to do that, why the f*** are you in a band?
Corey's like the special needs child of the band that you have to make sure that he gets his way, or else he just pouts and makes everybody's life miserable.
Are we going to San Francisco, Corey Craig?
Hell yeah!
Do you want to go? We're from Texas. We love San Francisco. Never been there, though.
Brandon is the singer. He's more the artistic type.
I'll give y'all all $20. I swear to God, if he does not say he's artistic or something or creative, he will say it. I guarantee it.
My role in this band is definitely the artistic side, the creative side.
Dude, we're all creative. We're in a band.
Dude, we are gonna get so gotta keep late this in this band. Dude.
This is the pimp mobile.
Fletcher's my brother. He plays bass. We've been playing together for years.
I'm like a weekend warrior. You know, I work. When we have shows, I go out and party down. It's great.
Hey, look, it's the Pacific Ocean, Fletch. Remember, we learned this earlier.
I live on the other side of town and have a wife and 2 dogs. I am number 5. I'm the guy added on to make Brandon a rock star so he didn't have to play guitar anymore.
Dom, you're in charge of the pager because you're like Mr. Page guy.
Beep-a. I gotta get Fletcher back. Give me that damn gun, dude.
Dominic's just an animal. I mean, he beats the hell out of those drums.
He's a maniac, you know? I mean, he's crazy. He pisses on my floor all the time, drunk.
We fight a lot, and then we get on each other's nerves so much, but still have the ability to get over it quickly. I gotta go see what they got.
Trip.
What's up, man?
Hey, how's it going?
Brandon. Hey, what's happening to those
Rex.
Did y'all get one of these cool guns?
No.
I see our van.
Oh, it's
we have the evilest van.
Because
we are
harlow.
We are meta.
Coming into this show, we'd done all of like 3 gigs in total ever in the history of Harlow.
We're kind of a baby band.
Here's the ladies.
I really love being in a band. I love feeling that I'm in a gang of women. I
think that her sort of just blind faith in things and blind faith in herself and being so unafraid has completely is what put this band together.
Shemaine is 15 years musician, total old school, worked her butt off to get where she's at.
Check it out, Rachel.
6 months ago, I was just clubbing with the girls when Amanda told me, you can play guitar, you can do it, I'll teach you, and we'll have the best band ever. And I told her, well, sure, there's one problem, I don't play guitar. And she said, don't worry, we'll take care of that. Stick with me.
We are still getting some ass.
There's just like a
you got cover. The
You know what, I'm gonna go say hi.
When I met Amanda, I didn't really play an instrument. She said to me, oh, come on, you know, let's make a band. I thought I would really love to learn how to play the drums. We started playing together for a couple weeks, and we sort of have created this monster that we call Harlow.
They have a spaceship. They have a spaceship.
You know, it's cool, but it's not as cool as ours.
Yeah, I already agree with that.
Band, friends, band members, gather around me.
All right, everybody, gather around. Hey, everybody, for those of you who don't know me, my name's Casey. I'm the tour manager for Bands on the Run, and we've listened to thousands of CDs. We auditioned hundreds of bands, and it all came down to you guys. You are the chosen three, so congratulations. Today, you three bands will drive to San Francisco, where you're going to play separate venues on the same night. And the band that makes the most money through ticket and merchandise sales will be the winner. Here are the rules. You guys have to decide the price of your tickets and merchandise. After each show, a VH1 representative will count and verify your takings from the door and merchandise sales. We're going to provide you with $20 per band member per day, a gas card, and a phone card. Okay, so now it's time to hand over all of your cash, your ATM cards, your credit cards, and your cell phones before you get on the road. Where are my helpers?
Blockbuster, Gold Card, GNC, Sam's.
No.
This sucks.
You giving them all your wallet?
And I've got your credit cards.
You look so sweet and innocent there. What happened?
Yes.
How are you?
I'm the good one.
All right, you guys, so that's it. Good luck, drive safe, and may the best band win. Woo!
Yes!
Yay! Good luck, boys.
Drive safe.
Yes. Okay, lock the doors. Here we go, ladies.
It's rockin' and roll, baby, rockin' and roll.
Can't have opening bands, but dude, we really need to pursue the possibility of something else. Dude, I'm so down with cheerleaders.
Cheerleader.
Stripper, dude. Let's go to the bar and get a stripper to come perform.
What t-shirt?
What t-shirt?
Dude, I'm so down.
Yes.
Holy.
Well, also remember San Francisco is the gay capital of the world.
Dude, hey, Noble. We go to gay clubs, we say we're gay. That is it. We say we are a gay rock band. Get all the gay people will come. We are cute.
I'm accessing the Soul Cracker combo. Lining up the contacts.
We knew that we had 2.5 days or so to promote the show. We needed to work real hard, and we needed to make the calls that we could.
We need to get as many people out to the show as we can. It's Thursday night.
We're experienced. We've been on the road for a long time, playing 260 shows a year. I don't think these other bands that we're playing with are very experienced with Rogue playing.
Soulcracker, how the hell did we catch him? We so rock, we so have made Meg a good time.
Maybe we'll be friends.
Plug sentences.
I think that's
cheese in
there. Why are you eating this?
That's better than boardwalk.
Is this what you felt like? You're sitting
our manager
at McDonald's.
Is doing the Atkins diet.
Keep feeding them. No offense, but I don't know how rock and roll it is, a guy in a band going on a diet. Really sissy.
I thought real rock and rollers just shoot heroin and don't eat anything.
Yeah,
you guys are... You doing?
Sorry I made fun of you.
Actually, I feel really excited.
With the Atkins diet.
Cheese girl.
You know, you don't need to be on it. He didn't know we were making fun of him, so now he's
still... Oh, whoops.
We're going to cover the girls' band in cheese and salami, right?
Perfect
I
idea.
I did that with 5 slices of cheese.
That's enough.
Rock show! Rock show!
Say cheese!
Oh! I can't believe there's meat on our van.
Remove the meat from the vehicle.
I can't understand what you're saying, you damn Brit.
Speak American.
They want me. They all want me.
You don't have salami on the Harlow windshield and get away with it.
Order the super value meal.
Who do they think they are?
They love your bald little head.
Eat the cheese. Eat the cheese. Eat the cheese.
Show us your cheese. Show us your cheese. We got not a chance. Well, from Asscracker,
it's on. War is on.
At some point, we're going to get them back.
I don't think they realize the mistake they've made.
I still think going to a bar and giving a couple of strippers a t-shirt.
I just want to get laid.
Yeah. I'm getting a little high from the pen fumes. I've done approximately 328 handbills so far, with only maybe 700 to go.
Go down Columbus, take a ride on Powell.
Columbus should be right around here, dude.
It's already broke the team. We're almost out of time.
Paradise Lounge.
These girls are offering us, you know, to try to show us some places where we can meet people for the show.
There's the Irish tour guide.
There's our little Irish tart.
Right.
She's the tart,
and
I'm the sweet one.
Put up some flyers.
We pull into town, get there, and trying to do some flyering and stuff.
When is it? 7
There's a number set up here.
7
We got to bed really late, like 4 in the morning. We don't need sleep. We can sleep when we're dead.
It only took us 17 hours to drive from LA to San Francisco. I'd say we're off to a really great start.
Oh, I'm dead. Okay, so we're not going out, right?
We're supposed to go out.
They're
gonna need that.
Nauseous.
Hey, there's a good attitude.
No, but they're going to...
It's true.
It's true. They're going to
do
that.
Yeah, you know
that,
what?
Because we're going to tear it up.
We gave them a head start.
Want to do some shopping?
Yeah, I do.
Are they coming with us?
I don't know if they're allowed to. Are they coming in the van?
I was very, very concerned about those girls riding with us because I was pretty positive that wasn't allowed. I don't know if anybody heard me. If they did, they didn't really speak up. Definitely Dominic didn't give.
They know to just back off. You know, if I start drinking a lot, then they just kind of back off and let me do my thing.
All the way to the back.
Dominic wants it 24/7. He's a sick, sick individual.
At 2 o'clock in the morning, I hate Dominic. I hate him. He's the biggest that has ever walked the face of the planet.
Hey man, this is business as usual.
Alright, so we've been here 30 minutes. We've already broken one of the rules.
What were the rules that?
That no one's allowed to ride in the van with us.
I'm Dominic Weir. I do what I want to do, and if you don't like it, that's what he says. Every night he says that to all of us.
Baby,
oh baby.
Oh baby,
you baby, know.
Oh baby, you know.
You know I got to see the boobies.
And we all let it slide every time.
Damn, Dominic. You know you got to show me. This is so
good. My parents
good.
Are gonna
this,
see this.
Your parents are not gonna see this.
Like she's really gonna go, yeah, come on home with the video camera and let's have VH1 video sex.
Oh look, I'm getting my
Now I'm starting to get a boner.
He doesn't care about anyone except his penis.
Did you show it?
I don't know.
I'm sure this
one. You're not dead.
You were there with him.
I'm not dead.
If his penis isn't happy, he isn't happy, and no one else around him is happy. Period.
So if we do it right now in drive time, it's huge.
Ramming speed.
I'm gonna turn around. My face is gonna be the other way, and then what are you gonna
do? Oh, Lord have mercy. Are you kidding me?
Dominic's tactful like an atom bomb.
I've got to tell him. Because can you not hear me?
If you think you've seen some wild rock and roll stories on VH1, you ain't seen nothing yet. Introducing Strange Frequency. Every week, different stories, different stars, different victims. Hosted by Roger Daltrey.
Who are you?
Strange Frequency. Rock's Twilight Zone.
Freedom's out.
Series premiere next Saturday at 10, 9 Central.
This isn't real.
Only on VH1. Another My VH1 Primetime Weekend Premiere.
For the student who sells the most candy, a weekend pass to Coastal Kingdom. To get out there and sell that candy.
The Volkswagen Passat. It only looks like $1 million.
Well, in the past.
Stop in the present.
Fast forward.
To the future.
Created by the producers of Queer as Folk, a new Showtime original series, Leap Years. The show follows five friends over 15 years in different periods of their lives.
How did I get here?
It's very much like a puzzle.
You want to know why the person ended up with that person.
It's not like anything else you'll see on TV.
Leap Years, life out of order. Tomorrow at 10:45 p.m. right after Queer as Folk, only on Showtime.
Charming Charlie, you look good. Ouch.
Don't forget, today's picture day.
Good days start with Fruit of the Loom.
Take aim. Fight signs of aging.
New Revitalift Complete with Pro Retinol A decreases the look of wrinkles, with Paralastal increases firmness and moisturizes, all with SPF 18.
Fight them all.
With new Revitalift Complete from L'Oreal Paris.
You must be hungry. Hungry. Let's go get some
brookie. Choo-choo like the moon goes do. Oh, yitty trusty wessy.
Oopsie, whoopsie.
Such a big girl in a swingy wingy.
A poo poo poo. Is Daddy Weddy home from Worky Jerky?
When you're in desperate need of a night out, you need Broadway.com and Visa.
How super
wonderful, Yusuf. I am the pentameter.
Visa, the preferred card of Broadway.com.
Canada Dry Ginger Ale. Out and out refreshment.
Are you planning on being a bachelor your whole life?
Not if I find the right girl.
Baby, cool, y'all.
American Outlaws. Rated PG-13. Starts Friday.
You know, most wireless plans offer you like a bucket full of minutes. But if you take a close look inside, you can't even see the weekday minutes. Oh, no. Oh, there they are. Oh, wait a minute.
Hello, little minutes.
The most whenever minutes, only from VoiceStream.
Chili's baby back ribs, double basted with barbecue sauce.
I think the first night we were in San Francisco, we got about 3 or 4 hours of sleep. We got up at 7 and worked all day.
We really wanted to stay motivated and stay focused because we really wanted to win. we instantly started flyering because we just really wanted a lot of people at our show.
Soulcracker has been around long enough to know there's a large portion of work that has to be done.
I guess we have it together more than a lot of bands.
Everything takes a whole lot longer being in a female band.
Everyone's in good spirits. We have hot beer.
I really need some Advil.
Everything, not just getting ready.
Take a four leg lock. Take a four leg lock. And I'm going to turn around. My face is going to be the other way. And then what are you going to do?
Then we need to be alone for a minute.
Never get anything done. We're never on time. Never make any decisions.
But today's a better day. We're going to be dangerous because we've actually had 5 hours of sleep now. So now we're just ready to go.
Hi there. I was wondering if I could speak to someone who deals with mornings on two.
We're going to call some people, see if we can get some radio interviews or get on TV or do something that's just going to make it really easy so we can just hang out and party.
My last name is Gibb, G-I-B-B, no relation to the Bee Gees.
Have some fun rather than having to go and actually do any work.
We're called Harlow. We're basically a rock band. We basically have got to promote our own show. We're open to anything. We can do an acoustic thing. We can just do a 2-second interview.
She's like, okay, all right.
Oh, Live 105, okay. You know, maybe even go down to the station so he can meet us girls.
She's very radio.
You know, at this point in time, we'll take anything we can get.
We got some plans. We're just waiting till the last minute. We're kind of, you know, next couple of hours. Things will happen.
We had just woke up. Dominic had our pager on, and our manager, Paul, paged him.
Hey, can you hear me? Okay, what's going on? Oh, Lord have mercy. Are you kidding me? I'm going to go ahead and tell Corey through the course of the day sometime. I've got to tell him because can you not hear me? Yeah, I guess you're right. We just got word that Corey's father passed away. His mother's really adamant about us not saying anything. No, I was talking to them. Corey is my friend. You know, I definitely had to step back and decide what I was going to do.
Dominic's tactful like an atom bomb. He got off the phone and comes up to us and goes, Corey's dad died, don't say anything.
I'm feeling pretty uncomfortable about knowing all this and him not. Probably gonna wait a little bit longer, wait till a little bit later on in the day, just because I don't want to kill our buzz today, kill our vibe. We got work to do.
What do you do? I mean, I was sitting there thinking about it all day, but still joking and trying to make the best of it because I had no idea what else to do.
I just wondering if we could hang like a couple of posters.
We're from Dallas. We forgot our boots and our hats. But my dad does own an oil well.
Oh, he does? Very good.
Not really.
I was thinking about it constantly, but I was like, I can't do anything and I can't say anything out of respect for his family.
We kind of messed up with the staying in the room thing.
All right, is everyone ready?
Yeah.
We're definitely going to win. We're going to kick their asses.
Oh.
Just make sure that everybody's together.
I say ready, and then I say, I know you said ready, and I said yeah, but you know what I mean.
We're definitely going to win. We're going to kick their asses.
Everybody has to strut the right way.
Can I get the garden burger, please? Where are we going today? We need to do something like a bit crazy.
Rock show Thursday. Can you write down shopping mall / department store?
We need to find a library.
Yeah, we have to go into the library today. Let's do that today.
There's a lot of ideas.
Try to plan it for later tonight.
I have
we can practice an acoustic song.
We want to get some Hell's Angels to drive us around.
Some of the ideas are a bit too wacky for me.
So shopping mall and Kmart.
If we can do the library and the shopping mall and a record store today, we're laughing.
We could do this, or...
I just don't want to talk about it over and over.
We're going to do stuff.
You could do it your way. I don't know. Your way's good.
Does anyone else think of something?
We never get anything done.
Can I call the radio station? We got into the van and the radio was on 92.7.
Well, that sounded like a good one. 92.7?
Yeah, okay. We're going to use the phone across the street. My name's Bob Hamill. I play in a band called Soulcracker. And we were wondering if there'd be some time that maybe we could, come in and just kind of maybe do like a quick little interview.
maybe on one of your shows. I know this is last minute and really strange. The pressure is really on us. But when I called, he was like very, very receptive right off the bat. And he said, well, look, if you can get here by 5:30, we'll put you on the air. So if we do it right now in drive time, it's huge. So we need to leave right now.
We have an interview during afternoon drive time.
Ramming speed.
Luckily, these guys are all blocking off our green light.
Those gridlock bitches, don't they know this is illegal?
How far away is San Jose?
61 miles.
Oh, we'll never get there.
Right there, left, 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 left.
Get in, hurry up.
Yeah, no, he can't get in.
Oh, I'm the closest thing you'll meet to say.
Oh, yeah, I think we're going to recruit him as our bitch.
I get a knock, and then they say, Corey, you need to call your mom. What's going on?
Think you and your friends will never hang out with Matchbox 20? Then you don't know Jacksonville. Win the VH1 Backyard Barbecue Sweepstakes and you and 25 friends are flying to Florida. You go to the Matchbox 20 show and meet the band. And the only place to enter is VH1.com. This sweepstakes is sponsored by Zenith.
Small to flat to thin, you can't escape the power of Zenith Digital.
Visit Head First Salon, the hair and nail care professionals who offer expertise in coloring and color refinement, superior customer service, and a full line of hair care products from Graham Webb. That's Head First Salon. Head First Salon offers all hair care services and a range of your favorite salon amenities. They also carry the finest in hair care essentials from Graham Webb, including Head Games, Vivid Color, Bebo Cosmetics, and more. Visit Head First Salon in the Crossroads Mall, 240-0405.
Are you looking to lose all the dirt and grime that's built up in your car? Stop by Quick Wax Car Wash in St. Cloud. Quick Wax Car Wash is a full-service location, which offers the latest technology in virtually touchless vehicle cleaning. At Quick Wax Car Wash, their knowledgeable staff will assist you on how to best pamper your vehicle. If your car needs a little more work, Quick Wax Car Wash also offers full detailing services. Quick Wax Car Wash opens 7 days a week, located on 33rd Avenue and Division Street. Look for the big red balloon.
How'd this happen?
I said I wanted to go hiking tomorrow, not bring home Charo.
Hey,
it's not even close.
I heard what I heard. Do you have a cellular phone? Yeah. It's the static. Here, Sprint PCS built the only all-digital, all-PCS nationwide network, so all your calls will be clear.
Thanks.
Here. Sir, ma'am, Charo.
Bye-bye, quick.
2,500 minutes for $39.99 from Sprint PCS.
Morning. How'd you sleep?
Good.
Ah, I slept great.
Must be that fresh mountain air, you know? Nothing like it.
Mm. Oh, man!
Introducing the Jetta wagon, with room for 70 cubic feet of anything.
Ah, the great outdoors. Mm.
$2 million is hidden somewhere in America, and 11 lucky people will stop at nothing to win it all.
This is the opportunity of a lifetime.
Go! To survive, they'll have to use their heads, follow directions, and outsmart the competition. Rat Race.
Help me, please! For gosh sakes, help me!
Ready PG-13. Sneak preview today. Check local listings.
It's 3 p.m. and we still haven't left the hotel. The other bands have been out since like 8 in the morning.
We've really got to
leave. Let's go, let's go.
We meet this guy at a bus stop named Josh.
Patty, excuse me. Yay. Please come to our show. We need people there. We're not from here.
Yeah, you want to give me a ride, and I'm welcome to come along.
No, what? We would totally.
We're not allowed to pass through.
Yeah,
I'll go
along
that way.
Yeah?
You know what?
Yeah.
We're not allowed unless we get it cleared. I don't think we're allowed.
Get in, hurry up.
Yeah, well, no, you can't get in.
Let him in.
It's not a release.
Within seconds, he jumps in the van and we're off.
Oh, hi. What's your name?
I'm Josh. What's yours?
Hi, Josh. Shemaine.
Nice to meet you, Shemaine.
Hi, we're Amanda.
Nice to meet you, Amanda.
How you doing?
Hi, Josh.
That's Rachel, Rebecca.
Hello, ladies.
No, it's just very forgettable.
I'm sorry. I don't mean to be anal, but it's just
that's
like...
That's Mumsy over there.
I remember seeing it in the rules. No one's allowed in our hotel. No one's allowed.
Well, that's going to be some trouble.
No one's allowed.
So do you have a lot of friends in this town?
Can you bring a bunch of people to our
Help,
show?
Please, in the name of Satan. We need people.
Hey, if you're going to say it's in the name
He's
of
not
Satan.
Okay.
Say in the name of Jesus Christ.
No, no,
no, no, no.
I'm in trouble. I'm the closest thing you'll meet to Satan.
Oh,
you like it.
Love it. In the name of Satan, I won't do it. In the name of Jesus, I really don't know if I'm going to sit this far.
You know Josh, you're more than welcome to hang with us. I think we're going to recruit him as our bitch.
You definitely were meant to be.
Rachel has so saved the day, probably saved the trip.
Do you know the way to San Jose?
We've got 3 minutes to get us there.
We're very afraid that we're not going to make it in time. If we do, it'll be huge.
And just follow this all the way down.
And if we don't, we wasted 3 hours.
Right there. Left, 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 no, left. 14. Yeah, this is it. Stop. I see it. Nice.
On time.
We made it. 5.9.
That's amazing. That
Weather Rock 92, KSJO.
We've got some guys in here from a band called Soulcracker from San Diego, which is my hometown. Very nice to have you guys in here.
Nice to be here.
Thank you. Explain this. Why is VH1 with you guys? Why are they following you around?
The whole thing is a big competition between the three bands to see who can generate the biggest buzz about them, generate the most revenue, have the biggest shows.
You've come to the right place.
We cannot stress the emergency of coming out to see this show.
Yeah, definitely everybody get out there. Do you know how the other bands are going about getting buzz going about them? I mean, what are
no
other...
idea.
Thank you so much.
You rock.
Man, that helps us.
Dudes are everywhere. It's sickening.
No way. Only way they could have got to them was on a ladder.
There you go, Soulcracker. I love you guys. Sorry, we're here a second.
We decided to go to Castro Street and just meet a whole bunch of homosexuals and drag queens and transvestites, and we're just going to get these crazy, glamorous people to come to our show.
We're going to go rock band. We're going to rock band. You come on and bring all your friends. It's going to be a blast. Everyone's going to dress up and get crazy and fabulous, and it's going to be really fun. So hopefully we'll see you there.
Basically, they welcome us with open arms.
Are you really famous?
Not yet, baby, but we will be.
Dominic got a page from something called Bay TV, which I assume is a local television show.
We were told that if we get a page, we should return it as soon as possible because it could be an opportunity to do some publicity.
All three bands were going to get a page at the same time, and the first band to call back gets an opportunity that the other two bands don't get.
I'm returning your page as fast as I can.
Wow.
Oh. That's okay. We tried.
I called the girl back from the Bay TV, and I don't know how this happened because we paged her, like, immediately.
Flick had got back to them faster than we did.
I said, no way, I can't believe it. What other band did you got? And she said, Flickerstick.
We were kind of annoyed about it.
So we're the only band three that got this.
We won!
See, our luck changed. Soulcracker was too busy promoting themselves, passing out flyers. Just sit in the van, and you'll get a beat, and we'll go right to the payphone.
All right, well, I gotta go get this fax. She's gonna fax me to the front
desk. I'm gonna make a phone call to a buddy.
Yeah, you go ahead.
Oh, boy, I gotta make a phone call.
Hello? This is Dominic?
No, we have been just on, like, going crazy, and I haven't been around the phone at all.
She wants Corey to call?
Okay, cool. Yeah, I'd so much rather that be the case.
All right, bye.
Gotta go get Corey.
get a knock. You know, and they say, Corey, you need to call your mom.
Okay, why?
But I didn't really think anything of it.
What's going on?
I could tell, like, as soon as I started talking to her that something had happened. When she said that my dad had died, it was like I got hit in the chest with, like, a sledgehammer.
Do you know what it was?
I hadn't talked to my dad in almost 5 years, I guess, mainly just because I hadn't called him. I have a stepdad and a mom, and maybe I just didn't need him.
Yeah.
The thing that hit me at that moment was he probably really needed me, and I wasn't there.
All right. Mm-hmm. I love you too. My dad passed away on Monday night. Sorry. I can't believe that. I really can't. It's crazy. You need some time to chill?
I don't even know. I'm totally freaked out.
I might not be the smartest or, you know, the quickest or the wittiest, but I understand human feelings.
His dad didn't try to contact him or even let him know that he was sick.
It wasn't like he died in a car wreck, you know, and man, I never got to say goodbye. He had cancer. It was a slow process. And he never called me. I may think that everything is going great, and then, bam. Nope, everything's not okay. You're not gonna get to be 40 years old and go, hey, Dad, I'm sorry. Hey, you know, I was a stupid kid.
San Francisco completely rules because there's a big bondage scene.
Oh, holy shit.
He was crying on my shoulder.
Our whole world has just exploded in 3 days.
If you think you've seen some wild rock and roll stories on VH1, you ain't seen nothing yet. Introducing Strange Frequency, Rock's Twilight Zone, Saturdays on VH1. On the series premiere, a roadie, a rock star, and a song from Satan.
Don't fear your desire.
Starring Roger Daltrey.
Who are you?
VH1 Strange Frequency, next Saturday at 10, 9 Central. Only on VH1, another My VH1 Primetime Weekend Premiere. Vans on the Run is sponsored by Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Speak now.
Okay, the hair needed a little change.
Nothing crazy.
So I picked up new Garnier Lumia Brightening Color Cream. It's
different because it permanently brightens your natural hair color without dramatically changing it. And it was like this for my hair. Not a huge change, just... Lumia won't dry out your hair, and it smells great. Now I feel boop-boop-bee-doop. Lasting luminous color. It's you, only brighter. New Garnier Lumia. Garnier. Trust them. They're experts.
Hey, what do you think? Boxers or briefs?
Oh, boxers? Oh.
Briefs.
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 Bikinis.
Bikinis.
Boxers.
Look,
no, I'm looking at this guy.
They're Hanes. Let's just leave it at that.
Oh, that was my God. I can't stand it. Oh, did you see? Yeah.
Excuse me? Dude, wake up. Hello, Yoo-hoo.
Just a reminder, Wendy's pickup windows open late, so you can get a classic half-pound double with cheese made fresh.
Get something?
And eat great, even late.
Bow your head!
Join the adventure that rules the planet.
Here they come.
And see the movie that Richard Roper says isn't just as good as the original.
Live dead.
It's better. Planet of the Apes. Rated PG-13. Now playing.
And now, a word from our sponsor.
Hi, folks. The name's Happy. Give me a chance before you zap me. I will try to hide what everybody knows. This is a commercial for Lucky Brand clothes.
Verizon Wireless connects more people in more places than any other wireless company. All on the country's largest wireless network. So you'll know that virtually anywhere you go, from the big cities to the small towns, your call goes through.
People everywhere just wanna be free.
Verizon Wireless. Join in.
We are now gonna start phase two of our promotion scheme.
Yes. Hot Which, strippers.
It does. It's really vague. It just, we know it has something to do with hot strippers.
Okay, we're approaching the Den of Iniquity.
We went to one of the clubs. They wouldn't let us in there, but there was this this lady.
American woman. Give me $1, I can break it down. Give me $1.
She said if I gave her $1, she'd do a good dance.
Get away from me.
I'm fine.
I'm scared, and Mom and Dad, I miss you so much.
So we just wanted to get out of there.
Oh, she's running
up. We decided as a group that we're going to go to a karaoke bar and do some singing. And then whilst we sing, we will promote our show and get people to go out to it.
Is Soulcracker ready? Is the entire band ready for this song?
You can either go in trying to impress them or trying to make them laugh. I go for the make them laugh angle.
I can't sing falsetto.
Hold it.
If you do either one, though, then they might be more likely to come see you play.
We play tomorrow.
I'm playing at the 7. No, it's tomorrow. Thank you.
You can come back to our house with us. We have a big house.
Hold on.
I have a tattoo here.
Did that girl just say you can come back to our house with us? Okay. Say that again.
We all love sex, drugs, and rock and roll more than anything in the world, but you gotta work hard, and then that stuff will come later.
I know when I should be serious.
Where should we go?
Where's a good place to go?
You can go back to my house.
No. We're looking for a place that we can promote our band more because we're playing tomorrow.
You're here at a gay bar with, like, straight girls, and you guys don't want to hang out with us?
I feel like we look like dorks because we're not out there partying our asses off. But if you want to be successful, you can't do that.
Do you want to go? We have 45 minutes left.
Yeah, let's go.
Come on stage and sing Prince with us.
Hey!
It'll be so fun. You guys. No.
All right,
and have a great
night.
How do you think the other
ways
are making
you check the smaller print? A little like this. Oh!
Harlow!
San Francisco completely rules because there's a big gay scene. There's a big, like, bondage scene. They're the kind of crowds that are going to really like our band.
All the characters in San Francisco gather at this bar once a week. Anything goes, leather and lace, boys and girls, but Amanda is the dangerous one. Amanda has a few relationships, boys and girls.
See, I'm just really sexually open and I don't really care. Like, I'm very honest and I'm not shy about sex. I just think it's really normal. So I meet this really cool chick and she's like totally sexy and cool. She is a car mechanic. And I'm just standing there going, you're so cool. You're totally cool. I'm gonna call her tomorrow morning. Everyone got really drunk.
We had a really, really good time though. We got to dance.
By this time, I am loaded and feeling really good. It was really relieving a lot of tension for me to finally be around what I would consider my own people.
Chicks dig.
We've pretty much decided that we're not gonna win and that we don't give because we're having fun.
It was a really great club and I hope that all the great people that we met there will come to our show.
All of us were way stressed out about Corey and what would he do and how do we react and how can we help him. And he wanted to try to go out.
We get to the bars and we start doing the shots and I mean, I really don't remember what happens.
Dom just flipped out and was just like totally different.
I gotta say, you're the most important person.
I would say too.
And he was just saying stuff like, I want my own show. Just saying like really strange stuff.
I can't believe you recognize, because nobody else does recognize. Nobody else recognizes my effort.
Keep it all together.
My pain, my sweat, my effort.
I am so staying away from Dominic.
It's tiny little things with Dominic that just scream, I don't care about anyone but myself. He comes over and sits down and gives me like a fake, like, you know, hey, how you doing?
You give us the third degree when he's the guy that we should be worried about.
What really happened is like, his father passed away and really like relit the fire of one of my best friends passing away.
And proceeds to tell me that he knows how I feel because he lost one of his best friends, who's a guy who cut his hair.
And we just turned around and made it all about him when Corey just lost his father.
Dude, his dad died Monday.
I know this. His feelings.
It's cool, dude.
Have this conversation far away from me right now. Have this conversation away from me. I'm done. Let's get serious. Get away from me.
I firmly believe Dominic got jealous because I think he thought, now Corey's gonna get all the attention.
And Corey was just like, I can't handle this. I gotta get out of here.
Corey took a taxi home. Dominic was just being very insensitive and Corey couldn't take it anymore.
In my opinion, he bought himself a one-way ticket out of my friend life forever.
You know, especially Rex got real emotional that night. He was angry that it was being exploited.
We signed up for it. We know the damn cameras were on us all the time.
I guess I'd never dealt with that before. It just seemed really, really awkward.
He was crying on my shoulder. I just kept telling him, I'm like, look, if Corey was worried about that, if that was bothering him, he would say so, and I guarantee those guys would have shut those cameras off.
It just really hit home with me. Our whole world has just exploded in 3 days.
Mm-hmm.
We're just going to ruin everything for them, basically sabotage it, upstage them. That's the plan.
I predict 200 people will show up.
And I'm going to say a little bit fewer than that.
And I'll say a little more.
So 200. You're right.
That'll do.
You don't need to film
them. It's unacceptable.
From the writer of Save the Last Dance and the choreographer of Dirty Dancing, a woman torn between the man she promised to marry.
He's cute, he's rich.
And the dance instructor who stole her heart.
Trust me.
The Way She Moves, a VH1 original movie.
You take a few dance classes and you destroy your future.
One dance can change everything. Premieres Wednesday, August 29th at 9. VH1, home of movies that rock.
When it comes to skirts, make mine a mini.
Keep it coming up, keep it coming up. Don't stop it now, don't stop it, no, don't stop it.
A little less skirt, a lot more leg.
Keep it coming up,
more leg, less money.
Don't stop it now, don't stop it, keep it coming up.
You gotta get this look. Only? I don't think.
And counting. The new 210 horsepower supercharged Nissan Xterra. Still everything you need, nothing you don't.
Ever wonder why people get sleepy after lunch? Maybe it's what they eat. If it's dull and boring, why bother facing the rest of the day?
Mission Control, do you ring? Hey, wake up, you guys!
Hello? Well, Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme has lively slices of mozzarella and a wicked parmesan sauce on a whole breast filet that's so delicious, you're bursting with go-get-em-ness. Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme. Wake up and taste the chicken.
We should have stopped at Wendy's.
Remember, Wendy's pickup window is open late, so you can eat great, even late.
You know how sometimes you get a little hungry and that voice inside says,
feed me.
Maybe it's time you were introduced to these little guys.
Discover Denon Snack Packs. All the good stuff big Denons have.
Only smaller.
She hates him and he hates her.
She thinks she's smarter because she graduated from Vassar and I went to driving school.
But the Jade Scorpion can make anyone do anything.
Marry me.
You dropped on your head?
The Curse of the Jade Scorpion, rated PG-13, starts August 24th.
It's time to join my space program. Organize your world with the new Martha Stewart Everyday Keeping products at Kmart. Workspace, office space, home keeping, clothes keeping, boxes, jars, bins, bags, and more. These new Martha Stewart Everyday products will keep your space working better for you. Get to Kmart and get organized. Martha Stewart Everyday Keeping on sale this week.
In the shadow of death, they risk it all. But why? On the Edge, only on the National Geographic Channel. No limits, no rules, no second chances. On the Edge, Tuesday at 9, only on the new National Geographic Channel. Always wonder.
Say you're watching Charter Digital Cable on a big screen TV.
A really big screen TV.
First, you scan the helpful on-screen guide.
So easy.
Then you take in more channels, choices, and all your local stations.
Note the higher quality picture and CD quality sound.
Of course, you can get this on your own TV, and it'll just seem bigger.
Charter Digital Cable.
Welcome
to the wired world.
This band means, you know, so much to me.
Rose above and, you know, pushed through and did what he had to do. I mean, he has got to be the strongest guy I've ever met in my life.
I never once thought about leaving. I was gonna stay. This is what I do, you know.
Fine, just go straight back.
Thank you.
Fantastic.
Look at God, the TV show. And we're pissed off about that.
Let's just go to war. Let's go to the TV station and just, can we just go in there and, like, interrupt their performance? It's got to be a live taping.
We have to try and get by the security.
Yeah, it's a good plan.
Let's go.
We're just going to ruin everything for them, basically. Sabotage it, upstage them. That's the plan.
That's great. Stand by in 10, 5, 4, 3, 2.
We have Harlow here, and they're going to be like,
we were like, kind of
no, they're not supposed to be here. And then I'm going to say, well, they told us to come. We've got our equipment and gear.
We're pretty excited, a little bit nervous.
This could be good. This could be good.
And you're clear.
What up?
Eat lunch first.
I just want to eat. That's all I want to do is get something to eat.
Tried to wreck our TV show. Oh, but you ain't wrecking no Flickerstick TV show, I'll tell you that.
Did you guys do your show yet?
Yes, yeah. We did.
Let's just bust in and go.
Hi.
What are you filming in here?
This is from Bay TV, the show.
Come on. This is where we're supposed
don't
to
be. Don't let them in.
They thought they were going to be on TV, but ha ha ha, they were not on TV.
It wasn't me.
Oh, wasn't it?
No way.
Don't say that.
They did this big production. Nothing.
We thought Soulcracker had a kid. Because we already, like, have our dislike with Soulcracker.
We covered up all their posters. We ripped their posters down.
Did you?
We work hard in a lot of areas where I think a lot of bands don't. The trick we've used before in new towns is just set up and play. Hopefully somebody will see you and like it. We were out looking for places to play.
We saw this sign that said free music.
We decided, let's make up a contact name.
Make up a name. H1. Debbie Langtree told us.
Debbie Langtree.
That's our contact person.
Yeah. Center for the Arts. She's from the Center for the Arts.
She's from the People for the Ethical Treatment of Artists.
Oh, Debbie Langtree from the, what is it, the Center of the Arts?
Yeah.
Supposed to. It's supposed to do what we're supposed to play, set up our gear over here and play.
Who said this?
Debbie Langtree. We're filming a documentary.
You have to have permits. Yeah.
Right.
The whole. You have it?
Well, we thought we got it through Debbie Langtree.
Debbie Langtree never made anybody. Doesn't matter who she is. She never. Right. She never called us or anything like that.
I'm just gonna.
And we have, you know, and I don't like that.
That'll do.
You don't even need to film.
You didn't really let us down, Debbie Langtree.
Seriously, come out to
we're gonna change this and we're gonna be like, okay, bring a friend to our show, have a drink, be on TV, see some. You know you guys are canceling your show, ours is gonna be funner. So hard in your life. Okay, here we go. You will so eat.
Bye guys.
See you.
Bye. See you all tonight.
All right, call us.
I'm
so gonna.
tag that lunch tonight.
Oh,
I'll
know you had. I'm going to still come.
No way, dude. I'm still doing it.
So, fuck your ass.
I'm going to see her naked tonight. We should go.
Pull up halfway on one of these curbs, BC. Just do it.
Let's do it.
We saw this nice open area where I could pull the van up and not be blocking traffic. So we said, oh, that's great. Perfect.
I don't know. We're probably at the 7th note.
We sat up in front of a police station.
All I can say is I am so excited to play a show tonight.
Oh my God.
With Rachelle. It's totally breaking her
Rachelle.
Virginity. It's the fourth show or fifth show that I've ever played.
He's in the chair tonight.
I'm nervous as all hell.
Please come see us play at the 7th note tonight with our soul cracker.
I predict 200 people will show up.
And I'm going to say a little bit fewer than 200.
And I'll say a little more.
So
maybe you're right.
He doesn't know where it is.
All right, you know where
it is? Ray leads greatest.
When we got to the club, we were a little surprised to see that Harlow was playing next door to us.
Hit Me Quick, parked outside up venue.
We thought you guys were sabotaging our show. I'm all like, they can't park there.
And then we realized they're playing next door to us. It means there's some sabotage potential.
The load up two flights of stairs.
The room's pretty big, and so I hope there's enough people to maybe make it look pretty full. We got 12 people on our guest list. I think all those people might show up. Dominic might have made some of them mad by trying to have sex with them, but I think we're probably going to get at least 12.
The bullhorn is coming down. It's law. It's law. I'm bringing it, and Hal's coming with me.
Harlow, they're raping us.
Come on, dude. Go, go, go. Come on, walk
out with Harlow. You guys, over there, you think I don't see you? Come inside. Come inside. Come inside. Come on. We're about to rock.
Hey, these chicks will bite you, and you will die immediately.
Come in. Chicks with the car. Strong rock hair.
That will suck your blood out. Run from the vampires, run! Why don't you go eat some babies, you sick witch?
Amanda and I were hitting it off so much.
Just fooling around.
I agree with you. I'm just going to caress my guitar. You know?
Oh my God.
Harlow Speedwagon was the hardest working band in rock and roll.
When Kevin and I were working well together, we were dynamite.
We brought the best out of one another. But it also made us crazy.
Too many tours, too much drugs, too many all-nighters, and drinking.
The band was burnt.
All I know is I woke up on my back in a hospital.
The Emmy-nominated VH1 Behind the Music.
I just said, I can't work with you anymore. I can't do it.
The REO Speedwagon Story. Tomorrow at 9, 8 Central. Another My VH1 Primetime Weekend Premiere. Sponsored by Kellogg's.
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Hey, let me in on that.
A man could get used to this.
Oh, yeah. That's the stuff.
Kellogg's Raisin Bran Crunch with sweet flakes and oat clusters. Tastes so good, breakfast is back.
This is Trickside.
The hit Under You. Order now.
Are you open?
Open to the new spirit of hair color? Introducing the first soft permanent color by L'Oreal. Open, vibrantly natural color gel. Low ammonia gel creating new soft permanent colors with botanical conditioners for soft touch hair.
Are you open?
Open to vibrantly natural color with layers of color and light. Now is the time. Get open, vibrantly natural color gel by L'Oreal Paris. The new spirit of hair color. Because you're worth it.
In a world consumed by war, a soldier will risk everything for the woman he loves.
When it's over, you will come back to me.
Nicolas Cage, Penelope Cruz, Captain Corelli's Mandolin. Rated R at theaters Friday.
Is there a problem?
Yeah, you whacked me pretty hard there.
Whack? No, I might have tapped it parking, but I didn't whack it.
Yeah, you slammed into me there.
Slam?
Look at this.
It's fine.
That's misaligned. You can't replace that. We'll have to get that in Europe someplace.
Okay,
well, look who's here. I'm glad you're here to see this. I can't drive this home, and my wife's upstairs giving blood. I don't know if I mentioned that.
The Passat wagon. It only looks like $1 million.
Oh, I'm not an internist, but I think I got some bleeding going on here.
Long-lasting extra. It's just gum until you run out.
Hey.
Chili's baby back ribs, double basted with barbecue sauce.
If you want to get attention, you gotta pay attention.
Come on, get up.
Look twice as good for half as much. Instant replay. Oh, yeah.
Do you want to party? Yeah. Do you want to dance?
Trust me, guys.
Come on and get down.
You got to get this look. Only at Old Navy.
Harlow for lovely vamps ready to make you roll.
Sound on the stage sounded good. I thought our, 12 people that we were rocking to were kind of getting into it.
I thought everybody was doing really good. I think that we played like there was 400 people there, you know?
We played really well, I thought. We were really energetic and had fun.
I was really disappointed with the turnout. I felt like we should have had a couple hundred people, like maybe 200 people.
If you'd like to purchase our album,
we were singing, and then the microphones were on, and that was good because there was sound coming out of them, and then the sound stopped, and then we sucked after that. I don't know what the deal is.
I think everybody's been so stressed out, and that was just like...
I think we were just pissed about the draw, and the mics went out, and we were like, fuck it.
Hey, we're gonna go pick up Harlow's show.
Harlow!
Thanks for letting us play.
That's great.
Yay. Harlow's rocking balls right now, so we're gonna go show Harlow.
I've got my eye on them, and they better not start any, or they're gonna pay. They have Worcester's shots, and I'm pretty happy about that.
Yeah, you can stop a rock and roll show with shots. I'll be honest, thank you very much for coming.
I think right now the plan is to get really, really drunk. We're going to hang out with the other bands.
Drinking got way out of hand, and I blacked out about halfway through it. I remember I hooked up with some girl.
Get some tongue, yeah!
His forward manner, I mean, I find it repulsive. I thought women like to be doted on and treated nice, and I guess I was wrong.
He's always trying to get to a hotel room or get to her house.
Left, which is never bad.
I'm sure they were probably pretty relieved to get rid of me.
What's that? Let me kiss.
We went to go hook up with the other bands. The other two bands were already hanging out, so we wanted to go and hang out with them.
How are you feeling?
Oh, it's wrecked. Oh, yeah.
There was this amazing wave of alcohol smell emitting from Flickerstick. Those guys were really, really wasted. And I didn't understand what happened. What did we miss?
It was crazy going to the hot tub when we went to the hotel.
Yeah. Get you up, girl. Whoa.
Isn't it best to be together? All the love happens at the end.
I'm in Harlow. I'm satanic. Let's kill a puppy.
The staff for the show was getting ready to tabulate all the revenue that the bands had made and tell us who won.
Attention band members, can you come to the front of the stage, please? We have the results of tonight's contest.
We lost!
Okay, listen, here are the results. On the door, Flickerstick with $130. Woo! Rollcracker with $245. Harlow with $330.
We were shocked as hell when they started reading out like the figures.
Merchandise sales. Flickerstick with $26. Merchandise for Harlow, $90. Soulcracker merchandise, $186. Now here are your grand total. Flickerstick, $156.
Third place. This
Harlow. Harlow, $120. Soulcracker, $431.
Now, I was amazed as to how close it was. We busted our asses to beat them by $11.
Considering we slept all night, $11.
We made more money on the door than anybody else, and that's what can count.
We'd like to thank the Legion of San Francisco.
We suck so bad. We so deserve to lose.
I'm an artist. I'm serious about my music.
We will tap for food or drinks. Preferably drinks.
We will tap for food.
Then I'm standing on top of our band, tap dancing with my brother.
No, no, you're not. You suck so hard.
What do you expect after 45 shots?
My musical integrity is just, it's completely gone.
I don't remember too much. I had quite a few drinks.
A big bottle of something.
We're in a rock band. You girls want to, like, move around, like, maybe, you know.
Don't worry about it, Soul Cracker. You guys are the winners. Relax. Everything's all good.
Why don't you go eat some babies, you sick witch?
Thank you very much.
Amanda and I were hitting it off so much, we were totally just fooling around.
See, we have LSD,
LSD, leads in your disease.
Yeah.
We are not allowed to touch any equipment.
I agree with you. I'm just going to caress my guitar, you know?
Oh, my God.
She was, like, all talking to me, like, come backstage, let's go hang out, just you and me, let's go hang out.
You know what? I never, ever tune my own guitar. Maybe I'll carry a bit of a guitar.
I'm in love with this girl. And, I mean, I was like, yes, I'm so, you know, at least going to mess with her. You know, like, whatever.
English accents drive me crazy.
Really?
Just hang out or, you know, something may happen. It's going to be kind of fun because, you know, we're two of us are in band. I was hanging out with her all night, blowing these other two girls off. Amanda's like, come ride in our van. And so this girl that was also talking to me, she's like, well, I want to go too. And I was like, yeah, you come with us.
You thought that this
going to be the right band.
I captured you. Come for our side.
Here, give me a good coat.
Amanda's here, and this girl's over here. And these two are all about each other. That's just my luck. That's my luck. That's our luck this week.
I'm trying to locate a guest. I'm not sure what the last name is, but they're like kind of vampire-looking chicks.
I think we did well in San Francisco.
I just woke up, and there was a boy between my legs. I don't know what happened.
It was a prophecy. I knew it. We won.
Past 4 days has completely changed my entire life.
If you think you've seen some wild rock and roll stories on VH1, you won't see nothing yet. Introducing Strange Frequency, Rock's Twilight Zone, Saturdays on VH1. On the series premiere, a roadie, a rock star, and a song from Satan.
Don't fear your desire.
Starring Roger Daltrey.
Who are you?
VH1 Strange Frequency, next Saturday at 10, 9 Central.
This is real.
Only on VH1, another My VH1 Primetime Weekend Premiere. Vans on the Run is sponsored by Volkswagen. On the road of life, there are passengers and there are drivers.
Hold on. We've got more prizes. For the student who sells the most candy, a weekend pass to Coastal Kingdom. So get out there and sell that candy.
The Volkswagen Passat. It only looks like $1 million.
Did you want to be alone?
No. Not at all.
Okay.
The irony is I started doing this to be part of the crowd.
Yeah,
now...
me too.
Oh, do you?
No, I just quit. Nicoderm CQ.
Aren't the cravings unbearable?
Well, I'm not jumping, if that's what you're thinking. No. CQ is good on the cravings. It's strong medicine. It's with you 24 hours. It works.
Nicoderm CQ, now in a clear patch, too, for a more personal way to quit.
Quit, huh?
Hey, join the crowd.
Are you ready? Go!
Y'all ready for this?
Six teams are competing for $2 million.
Yeah, right!
But only one can win. Will it be the mother and daughter? They'll try anything.
We're looking for the interstate.
There's a dandy shortcut.
But sometimes take it too far. Odds 50 to 1 today. Place your bets. Rat Race. Rated PG-13. Sneak preview today. Check local listings.
Not everything can be as good as the original.
I wish I lived in Wisconsin.
But Diet Dr. Pepper is. It tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
What's this? It's Ambipure. The first 2-in-1 liquid air freshener and bowl cleaner. Ambipure constantly freshens your bathroom, and cleans the bowl for up to 30 days. AmbiPure, a great way to freshen your bathroom.
Wendy's makes late nights great nights, serving up your favorites.
Hello?
Get a Wendy's classic half-pound double with cheese even late, because our pickup window's open late.
A big Wendy's thank you goes out to the man in the red minivan.
Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs is coming to Disney DVD for the first time. Critics say prepare to be amazed. Pre-order now and receive a Disney DVD free for a limited time only. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, reserve your copy today.
Are you looking to lose all the dirt and grime that's built up in your car? Stop by Quick Wax Car Wash in St. Cloud. Quick Wax Car Wash is a full-service location which offers the latest technology in virtually touchless vehicle cleaning. At Quick Wax Car Wash, their knowledgeable staff will assist you on how to best pamper your vehicle. If your car needs a little more work, Quick Wax Car Wash also offers full detailing services. Quick Wax Car Wash opens 7 days a week, located on 33rd Avenue and Division Street. Look for the big red balloon.
If you like movies, we mean really like movies, you're gonna love the Charter Digital MVP package. Get crisp digital picture and sound so you can enjoy multiple premium movie channels from Showtime Unlimited and the HBO Max Pack, bringing you thousands of movies and originals every month, all for one low price. The Charter Digital MVP package. It's better TV. You'll see.
You got sweet, sweet loving last night, dude.
Yeah, I know.
It's got to tide you over. I feel good.
Whenever we all first got here, I think maybe I felt like I had to be on. I had to be Corey. And whenever I got the phone call, I just kind of realized life's going to go on around me, and there's going to be some times when I can't be on, and it's impossible to be an entertaining person.
I just woke up, and there was a boy between my legs, and don't know what happened.
I think we did well in San Francisco.
We had so much fun. Totally successful. I think that we pretty much came out of it smelling like a rose. Well, not literally.
We were in Venice Beach, and she said, okay, may the best band win. I said, we will. It was a prophecy. Anyway, we won.
This whole crazy situation, from the band to my life, has made me realize so many things about myself and my relationships with other people. It's not going to be about me anymore. I don't want it to be about me. I want it to be about the people that are around me. Past 4 days has completely changed my entire life, so. I think when we get back to Dallas, everything's gonna be the same on the surface, but everything to me, everything that I thought was true in our band has become untrue. So close to my dad when I was younger, like until I was about 10 years old. I was closer to that side of the family, my mom's side of the family. I don't know what changed. I don't know if I changed so much that it was hard for them to accept me. I don't know, but somewhere along the way, we just kind of lost each other.
It's scary because his father was only 50 years old. I mean, you think that there's 20, 30 years to take care of business and mend fences.
Do you have any copy of the obituary or anything?
Mm-hmm. You want to see it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I wanted to be here for the services, but I had a job to do. I didn't want to let the other guys down.
There's a lot of people there?
John counted about 75. Yeah, it's a nice service.
I don't know if I'm mad at me or if I'm mad at him. I'm mad that He didn't call me. I don't understand it.
Let's do it.
Okay.
I feel lost. Marissa and I have been talking like over the last 6 months that I needed to call my dad. You know, I've been dealing with like these issues and like trying to grow as a person a little bit. It's like, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow. And there's not a tomorrow. I know we would have reconciled. I know we would have. One phone call on my part. One phone call.
Do you want to tell yourself to talk to me?
I wish I could have seen him. Before he died, I wish I could have seen him. Before he got buried, it's really weird because it's like I look at flowers like that and it's like, that's all I got. The one thing that this situation has helped me realize is that it's hard to find people that love you and care about you unconditionally, I think. If I go out on the road and I break up with Marissa and I lose her, it's the same kind of death, I guess, in some ways, because it's me losing someone that I love and care about and that loves and cares about me because I'm stubborn and because I'm selfish. Yeah, let's go. I don't want that to happen.
First short tour, we went off to San Francisco. It's kind of a little test run.
Where are we going?
To the airport.
Yeah, where are we really going?
They absolutely told us nothing. We could be on tour for 3 weeks, we could be on tour for 2 months.
I'm more concerned about making it through this than I really am about who wins each show. I want to spend the next 8 weeks avoiding real life somewhere else.
We've added a fourth band, and I'd like you all to welcome the Josh Dodes Band.
We're also the only band that didn't have the benefit of working on the pilot, and we were already thinking about how to play catch up.
And I really, 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 really want to win it.
This is war.
Do you know how bad Soulcracker think they're gonna win?
Our mission tonight is for everybody to leave with a CD.
Work hard because only two of the four bands are gonna make it to the end of the tour.
I don't have time to waste on bull. I'm here to win.
We're constantly making choices on the fly here.
I'm like Bandage!
We definitely wanna win. Basically, we were gonna try to, like, not break up.
I'm sure it'll be a crazy ride.
Well, that thing's not gonna suck itself.
Into the groove, eh?
They're not promoting tonight, they're all gonna get laid.
I spent all my money, well, not all of it, but most of it, buying a bunch of boys' drinks last night.
Which seems to have paid off.
How many men have I had sex with?
You're a whore.
I can feel it's getting a lot closer during this tour.
I'm not kidding, Fletcher. Shut up, you.
Shut up! Shut up! You too! Shut it!
They're probably gonna win anyways, because they're such...
Stop whining, dude.
I'm not whining. I'm just being realistic.
Fight about stupid.
The thing is that he should have
been gone a long time ago.
If I had it my way, I would pack my shit up and just get the out of here.
If the five of us can't find a way to pull this off, go back to your day jobs, boys.
Damn it, it's my 45 minutes.
We have 55 possible more days. If I gotta listen every night, I would quit this show and take all y'all down with me because I'm not gonna feel it.
Go deeper into Bands on the Run at vh1.com.
Previously on Bands on the Run.
We're really frustrated that we've been working our asses off and haven't really seen the fruits of our labor.
We're good at focusing on one thing, and if we focus on just playing, we will be successful.
Pittsburgh sucks.
Pittsburgh sucks.
Pittsburgh is like kryptonite to Harlow. It's made us weak and useless.
You know, we're doing good. Let's keep it up and work twice as hard because we don't want to go backwards. We got to stay in the game now that we're doing good. Keep pumping hard, you know.
And then this girl walks up and I'm like, oh my God, that girl's amazingly gorgeous. You know, I don't want to hurt Marissa, but it's like, I just feel like I owe it to myself to maybe kind of see like what happens.
VH1 picked four independent bands, put them on the road.
Cameras falls everywhere.
We play the same towns, different venues every night.
And we live on $20 a day.
We only have 2 or 3 days to promote each show.
Whichever band can draw the most people and make the most money will stay on tour, and the people that don't make as much
will be kicked off and sent home.
Good morning. We're number three.
We're number four.
Butch?
What's going on, buddy?
How you doing, man?
I'm doing pretty good.
Hey, you try to scare us! I hate you!
Good, man.
I hate you. I'm glad you're in a good mood, man, because we were about to kill you. Where were you, man? We just faced you 2 minutes ago.
I was out at a log cabin somewhere.
He can fall for a girl really quick, you know? If he meets a girl that he just thinks is drop-dead gorgeous, he can't help himself.
I knew when I had to be back. I'm trying to make nobody nervous.
I don't know if this is something that just kind of happened and he thought is good and he'll realize later is something that he shouldn't have done, or whether he really likes this girl. I have no idea how he's going to work this out for himself.
Hey, that chick is hot. She's going to come to a couple of shows.
I don't know how he's going to pull that off. And Marissa, his girlfriend, wants to come down too and like see him sometime. I'm like, oh man.
It's all innocent, right? Nah, dude, it's fully not innocent. 100% uninnocent.
Right on, dude.
One fan at a time, baby.
Harlow, Flickerstick, Soul Cracker, Josh Dodes Band. Let's find out how you guys did in Pittsburgh. In fourth place, we have Soul Cracker with $2,990. Third place, the Ladies of Harlow with $3,007. And in second place, Josh Dodes Band with $3,067. And in the lead right now, after three cities, is Flickerstick with $3,331. Now the pressure's really on, because one of you bands will not be going any further than the next city.
Each band will play a separate venue in 2 days' time. Then two nights after that, you'll all share the same venue for a battle of the bands. The outcome of these two shows will determine which band is getting cut from the tour.
Your next city on the Bands on the Run tour is Columbus, Ohio.
One city to go, it's definitely anybody's ball game.
The best way we can stay in the running is to play as much as possible, sell that merch, to stay on the show.
I think that the elimination's not going to be a problem. We're not going to do anything different than we've been doing. We're just going to hopefully it'll work again, you know?
Like, I don't want any of the bands to go home. I'm kind of having a fondness for all of them. And we're all just so different. It's going to be really hard to... And how are they going to kick someone off? It just kind of breaks my heart, the whole thing. I just wish we were all doing the tour all together for the whole time.
This is correct. Our club should be right by the campus.
I do. I think it's going to be all about the college on this trip.
We're thinking we're coming into a big college town. We're thinking we might have a cool shot at getting ahead, further ahead, I guess, just because there's so many kids and, you know, we're the party band, obviously.
I'm almost on the tip of the sororities, just the chicks, you know? Because where there's girls, there's going to be guys.
I think everyone realizes that there's a little bit more at stake now than there was in the first couple of cities.
I want to cover our ass in case we need a cover. That's why I want to do the merch swap.
The merch swap with us and Soulcracker? I think it was Sutton that came up with the idea.
The thing is that I personally just don't want to be involved, but I think it's a great idea.
It's one hand washing the other kind of situation, so we thought it was going to be a very good, you know, a very good thing for both bands.
Yeah, why don't you want to be involved?
What do you mean you don't want to be involved?
I just think it's a sneaky move.
It is sneaky,
but
what's
wrong with
that? The game. I don't think that's being mean or backstabbing anybody. I think it's being competitive.
I completely understand and respect that you guys are in it to win.
But you're not? Are you serious?
Well, no, I mean, I want to win. I'm not saying that, but that's not the main reason I'm here.
What is the main reason you're here?
To have a good time and to meet these bands and to chill out. Like,
yeah,
I mean,
it's totally different for me.
Totally different.
And you know what? That is totally cool. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's not like I don't want to win, you know? It's not that at all.
All I'm saying is that if you want to do this, that's fine. This is a democracy. If there are 3 votes against 2, I will be 110% behind you. It's just not something that I will personally do.
We're extremely excited to play your club this Thursday night. I'm sure you are aware of what's going on over there.
Hey, are you the 3 hot rockin' chicks?
We are. There's actually 4 of us. The more the merrier, I always say.
What do you need us to do? Because we'll do anything you want us to.
Oh, that's cool. Well, basically, we sucked really bad in the last town we were in. And this is the town where someone's going to get kicked off the tour. This is kind of like Rock Survivor. And so we basically just need to get as many people as we can to the show and sell as much merch as possible.
We get a page saying that there are 2 frat parties that night on OSU's campus, and each party can accommodate 2 bands, but that we have to find the frats.
Ball sack.
Here we go. We gotta get to a phone. 911,
dude. What?
Hey, he talked to
me there. Stop sign, take a right.
It is the bonus op, although there is no reward fee, basically. But you can sell merchandise.
The game is to go there and look for it.
We're Flickerstick. We're just driving up. We didn't call. We just came straight here.
Okay. If you guys want to set up, I'll set you up right here.
Let's do it.
Oh, is it tonight?
Yeah.
All right.
As soon as we get this information, immediately sent Soulcracker the page.
Yep.
We managed to get to the frat house first. We set it up for both bands on both bands' behalf. We've already been talking anyway about doing a gig together.
We at Soulcracker got the numbers for the 2 places and booked both of them.
How do you get to your frat house there? I'm at 17.
And to us, that was just normal, you know? It's just the way we do things, book as many shows as possible.
He said that Soulcracker called and booked to play later, but Flickerstick is there.
That's 2 for Tony's.
Yeah, I know. I called the other frat house to say, hi, I think we're playing there tonight. They're like, no, Soulcracker's playing here with Josh Dodes.
Hey, don't say anything to Soulcracker about anything, you know what I mean?
They're playing at 8. They have another show at 10.
We got to the fraternity house and we found out Soulcracker were playing both frats that were hooked up with the show.
Play at 8.
They have another show at 10.
I don't know.
They booked another show like we should have done.
I was pissed. I wasn't too happy about Soulcracker.
Have you heard the bids?
Yeah.
Soulcracker is double booked.
They're playing at Teak.
They're playing at Teak and they're playing here. I have
so
really
maybe we should offer
about
Harlow
it.
I think that's disgusting.
Here.
Like, they were supposed to get in touch with the sound guy.
They took that time instead to go book another gig that they didn't even mention to us, even though we got them this one.
Okay.
That's fucking
well,
us over.
Period. Then,
any other time, but in the elimination week.
We said to them on the way down.
Yeah.
Do you guys want to book together? They said yes. We got here first. We set up the gig for them.
Right.
We wrote them about it, whatever. They did, they did not do the same for us. In other words, they screwed us.
Well, you can't do that.
Yeah, we can.
This is just turning into a bunch of bull.
My Mondays on VH1 Primetime. You pick it, we show it.
All you gotta do is cast your vote.
Cast your vote.
Cast your vote.
Go to VH1.com now and choose what you want to see. Then tune in Mondays at 9, 8 Central to see it. It's that simple.
It's about time someone asked my opinion.
Watch what you want. My Mondays on VH1.
careful. That's a Zenith digital TV you're looking at. From big to small to flat to thin, you can't escape the power of Zenith digital.
At least you can eat like a man. Ballpark Franks. They plump when you cook them.
Bow your head!
Join the adventure that rules the planet.
Here they come.
And see the movie that Richard Roper says isn't just as good as the original.
They're dead.
It's better. Planet of the Apes. Rated PG-13. Now playing.
You used all your quarters over the payphone, didn't you? Next time, dial down the center with 1-800-C-A-L-L-A-P-P. It's free for you and cheap for them. By the way, this one's hot.
Save big bucks on every call. Just dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Well, in the past.
Stop in the present.
Fast forward.
To the future.
Created by the producers of Queer as Folk, a new Showtime original series, Leap Years. The show follows five friends over 15 years in different periods of their lives.
How did I get here?
It's very much like a puzzle.
You want to know why the person ended up with that person.
It's not like anything else you'll see on TV.
Leap Years, life out of order. Tomorrow at 10:45 p.m. right after Queer as Folk, only on Showtime.
Morning. How'd you sleep?
Good.
Ah, I slept great. Must be that fresh mountain air, you know? Nothing like it. Mm. Oh, man!
Introducing the Jetta wagon, with room for 70 cubic feet of anything.
Ah, the great outdoors. Mm.
The first full-length animated motion picture ever created is now the first fully immersive DVD experience. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, the first DVD with an interactive personal guide.
Prepare yourself to enter a world you have only imagined.
Critics say prepare to be amazed. Pre-order now and receive a Disney DVD free for a limited time only. Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Reserve your copy today.
You know how sometimes you get a little hungry and that voice inside says,
feed me.
Maybe it's time you're introduced to these little guys.
Discover Denon Snack Packs. All the good stuff Big Denons have.
Only smaller.
You know what they've done is they've double booked to basically cover their asses. This guy's freaking out. He says that we can't play the other party because you guys are already playing.
Yeah, we are.
Well, you can't do that.
Yeah, we can.
That's not cool, man. That's lame.
No, it's not.
Soulcracker are kind of pretty hard ass when it comes to this game. So competitive and sneaky. Like, it's not very rock and roll.
You know, what we did was fair and square, that we booked these two shows on our own. That's all we were trying to do, is make as much money as we could and play as much as possible.
Wow, there's so many boys here.
Super
I want to play here.
We didn't think that we couldn't just book a show, book two shows. I mean, we thought it was like, you know, a race.
We were already set up. We were ready to go. And we decided that we'd play a short 25-minute set at that fraternity. And then play a set at the Lambda House.
Oh.
Cold fire.
Hell yeah, man.
Told us we couldn't play in either place for Soulcracker. I booked both places.
This is just turning into a bunch of bull.
I think they're so concerned with winning that they don't even realize some of maybe what they're losing in the process.
So you aren't playing?
No, we're going to play, but Soul Cracker's already played, then you're playing, now we're playing third here. But you know what?
So why don't you say something?
Because I think we're going home in a few days anyway, and I'm really, I don't
well,
really care.
Maybe you wouldn't be if certain people
you
play by their
own. You know what, honestly?
Y'all do know this is a competition, I'm sure. Soul Cracker told y'all about it. And yes, for the record,
we don't get along with those guys.
If you really want to see a cool show, go to the Ruby Tuesday. Don't go where that other band is playing. My God, trust us. Y'all just heard. You know why they had to get out of here so fast? Because they had to go play one of the other fraternity parties they thought was way cooler. We ain't lying, dude. They're at another fraternity right now playing. We told them we wouldn't do that. We were going to play one and one only so we could hang out and meet you guys.
Wait, so you guys are also playing Teak?
We just did.
You
played
did?
A half hour set there.
Yeah. Oh.
No one told us that we can only book one show.
Yeah, no, I know.
So we booked a show at Teak, and then we booked one here.
Part of the way that you guys were able to get the Teak gig was because you had the time to do it while we were rushing here and dealing with the tech guy and giving them your sounds back.
Oh, okay. Total misunderstanding, because I thought you guys were playing a different place.
There's a misunderstanding about Soulcracker's tactic in trying to play both frat parties that at first glance seems to be a sort of stabbing in the back.
All we knew was we got these two numbers, and we call them.
Fine. You know what? Fine. Let's kick ass tonight, all of us.
Okay, where's Joel?
He's out here. He's in the doing the sound check.
So you don't.
I don't want to be fighting with those guys, you know. I don't want to be fighting with anybody, but particularly with the one band that I feel I have the most respect for and that I have the most trust in.
People get over the fact that we're playing three gigs tonight. I mean, are we supposed to not play four if we have to? You know? I don't. It was just that it put them in a weird position because they were generous enough to save us a spot here.
They probably went to the hotel room, Harlow, hung out for a while. You know, it was like 2 hours later that they arrived.
We had totally figured it out, booked it, booked both places, come up, set up everything, and we're ready to play.
Here we go. This is a song about New Jersey called Do the Duke.
Were like the third band at the frat party we were at, and by the time we played there was only like 15 people left. You know, it kind of sucked for us.
Thanks a lot, everybody. We're promoting a show we're playing Thursday night at Northburg Tavern, and also we'll be running a kissing booth.
This is a song about sex with strange women. Why did I just say that?
Played the frat party and that kind of went terribly wrong. We just decided, you know what, let's just go to our venue, check out where we're playing, let's just have some fun. We walked into the High Five and it was like being back in LA. We met Nikki. She doesn't even need anything said about her. She is just the fifth member of Harlow all the way. And the club owner, Diana, was fabulous. I went up on stage and said a few words to break the ice.
We just got into town this evening and we're
we're competing against boy bands that are like up at 7 and go for a jog, and we're just like drunk falling over being really useless. We're the last town before the first band gets booted off, and we can really use your house.
And we danced to Saturday Night Fever till like, you know, 5 in the morning. And we had a Harlow team, serious Harlow team on our hands that basically came everywhere with us.